Now, is this the best way for anyone to learn Next.js? Let's see. Vercel recently announced a revamp of their learning platform aimed at teaching you to use Next.js. I've gone through the whole course and I'm here to tell you the good, the bad, the ugly, and what I think of it all. Let's dive in. First, the good parts. There are five things that I appreciated in this tutorial. The first thing, of course, is that it is free. Of course, Vercel are not doing this out of the kindness of their heart. They're pushing for wider adoption both of Next.js and of their own platform. But nevertheless, you can't beat free for the price. The second thing is that this comes from the horse's mouth, the creators of Next.js. And bonus point, they work closely with the React team. So the course highlights the strengths of Next.js and teaches you the best practices of React. Things like how to use the suspense React component and skeleton fallbacks, how to best fetch data to provide an optimal user experience and the quickest possible page load. The third thing is that you learn by doing. This is due to how the course has been set up. You start by cloning a repository, which provides an existing code base to work from. This allows the course to focus on teaching you the essentials. By allowing you to get your hands dirty, you don't spend time on unrelated things. You don't just get the theory. You get practical examples and hands-on experience. The fourth positive thing is the scope of the course. It covers the basics, of course, but then it dives deep. It has you connect to a Postgres database and then fetch and mutate data and paginate and use server actions and manage errors and authenticate the user using auth.js and use middleware to protect specific routes and much more. The fifth thing, is that at the end of the course, you have the basis for a Next.js application that you built. Admittedly, with a bit of help. But it does give you a good starting point that covers 90% of the subjects that you might need. Now, all that sounds rosy, but is everything perfect? Far from it. Let's take a look at the bad. There are four things that I found less than optimal in the tutorial. The first one is hopefully temporary. The course has bugs. Nothing fundamental, but they can block you from progressing. For example, at one point, it tells you to import a component from a specific path. However, the path that it provides is incorrect. The course also provides snippets that highlight specific lines to tell you what to change in your code, except that the highlights don't cover the changes that you need to make. Now, I got through all that, but I already know Next.js, so I'm not exactly the target audience. And this brings me to my second point. If you're stuck, you're stuck. There's no support, no forum that you can turn to for additional help. I'm not complaining, it is free after all, but a community-driven way of providing help might be needed. My third disappointment, which might also be temporary, is that the experience is a lot less gamified than the previous iteration of the course. I liked getting points for completing exercises or answering quizzes. There's still a bit of that left. Your progress is tracked, and there are quizzes, but it's not up to par with what there was before. The fourth sticking point is that the tutorial ropes you into the Vercel ecosystem. Now, it's cool that it teaches you to deploy your website and to use Vercel's storage solution and so on. And fair enough, the course is free, and Vercel is obviously the preferred solution of the creators of Next.js, since they're the same people. But there's more to Next.js than just Vercel. There are other worthwhile solutions to explore. So, what conclusions can we draw from all this? Well, first, the course is a good investment of your time. It's free, it's worth looking into and trying out. I've no doubt they'll fix the hiccups that I came across, and maybe even improve the user experience. So I recommend that you give it a try. Second, well, the course has inspired me to try and build my own courses. I haven't created any. This is not me trying to sell anything to you. But if you'd like to be notified when I do finally release a course, or indeed when I release any new content, I'd like to encourage you to sign up for my newsletter. I've provided a link in the description. And if you're interested in learning more about Next.js, here's a video where I cover everything that was said at the last Next.js conference.